Can I ask you for your reaction to the use by the President of the United States of the N-word in that podcast interview? What did you make of it?
No, I thought the President Obama, he told the truth about just how deep the legacy of white supremacy actually is. But you know, the irony, Hala, is that there's a sense in which President Obama is himself a niggerized president, in the sense that a niggerized black person is a person who is afraid, intimidated, and scared of fighting the vicious legacy of white supremacy, putting a premium and spotlight on the vicious legacy of white supremacy. President Obama's been running from the issue of race for almost 6.5 years. And so in that sense, when he used the word and talked about how deep it cut, he's absolutely right. But just a few weeks ago, he talked about racism wasn't endemic. It was just incidental. I said, no, it's vicious, my brother. But he's telling the truth now, and I agree with him.
But, Professor, here's the thing. People say this type of rhetoric coming from you is actually extremely divisive. You're no fan of President Obama.
I don't mind.
You even said he was a Rockefeller Republican in blackface.
I was telling the truth.
Why are you so hard on President Obama? He's the president of all Americans.
He behaves like a Republican, a Rockefeller Republican. I'm telling the truth. I don't mind being divisive, my sister, if I'm telling the truth. If they show me that the connection to Wall Street, connection to drones, the connection to massive surveillance, not hidden prison industrial complex, the child poverty rate escalating, black poverty escalating, black middle class status declining, all of these are truths. If they point out that they're not truths, I pull back. But I don't mind being divisive at all. I'm trying to tell the truth, that's all.
But it, being the president of the United States of all Americans presents a particular challenge, does it not, for the first black president?
Absolutely.
That he is not the spokesperson of the black. I mean, this is the balance he needs to find.
Political calculation with moral conviction, but a president must have moral conviction. You know, and I know, for example, that in Europe, they use the Confederate flag as a substitute for the Nazi flag. The Confederate flag for black people is a Nazi flag. Now, does that mean political calculation and X and Y have to be considered? No. Certain things are a matter of moral conviction. Same is true with black poverty. Same is true with working class situations. Same is true with homophobia. Same is true with anti-Semitism, anti-Arab racism. There are certain things that are non-negotiable. But I begin with black people. Black oppression is non-negotiable. Black president, criticized. White president to be criticized. Across the board, that's how I roll.
And you don't think with this use of the N-word, with him bringing up the fact that racism is ingrained within the DNA of the country as the first black president, is taking a stand? You don't think that's enough?
Oh, no. I said I'm glad he did. This is after almost 7 years. I said he's telling the truth. Anytime anybody tells the truth, no matter what color, I'm for him, Dohala.
Let's talk about the Confederate flag. We're expecting the governor of South Carolina, Nikki Haley, to come out. We're expecting her to say she believes it should be taken down.
She's right. She's right.
Yeah, I expected that you would say that.
And I'm not used to agreeing with right-wing Republicans like her, because she's wrong most of the time.
Right, but you think in this case it's right and you think it will go ahead?
I think so, yeah. I think given the atmosphere right now, we're going to take down a vicious flag that symbolizes enslaving black people and making sure every Negro is under white domination. I think it's about time to take that flag down. Yeah, I think so.
But there are some who say in the South, they say this isn't a symbol of black oppression. This isn't celebrating the Southern states' reliance at the time of the Civil War on slave labor. It's our heritage. It's part of our heritage. What do you say to that?
I say that if your heritage is one of killing black people, maiming black people, murdering black people, it's time for you to give up that heritage and try another one.